Hey y'all, welcome back. Today I'm showing you guys some highlights of my kitchen, like simple storage solutions or like organizing ideas. I was gonna do like a full kitchen tour. I was like, yeah, they might enjoy that. But after I was done, I realized just how lengthy it got, and I figured you probably didn't want to listen to my whole 20 minute plus version of my kitchen tour. That might get a little bit boring and long-winded, so I have a bad habit of that, like I'm doing right now. Anyways, I am gonna show you the things that I like to use in my kitchen and the things that work well for me, and some different storage ideas. So I am just gonna jump right in and get started. Okay, so I'm just gonna give you an overview of what my kitchen looks like. Most of you, if you followed me, are well aware of how my kitchen looks, but I figured I would just show you. There used to be a wall here where I was showing there along the floor over to the edge of the fridge. So there was like a tight little doorway. So we took that down before we ever moved in, and boy, are we ever thankful we did. But yeah, it's a pretty small kitchen, but I've tried to make the best use of space. I have a small, somewhat of a pantry in another area, but I'll show that in another video possibly. Here in the first cabinet, I'm just going to show you my favorite cabinet of all. This thing makes me so happy. What I want to show you is the back is black. Now, I got this tip from a blog I was reading, and they took poster board from the Dollar Tree and just tacked it to the back of the wall. And that's what I did to these cabinets here. And it was so inexpensive, and I feel like it makes everything pop. And now what you're seeing here is one of my favorite bins that I use in my cabinets. I got them from Walmart, these copper bins, and they just keep everything nicely corralled, and yet they look really pretty. I have a big love affair with copper, but this is kind of my coffee and tea station, this little cabinet here. So as you can see, I have my straws and my tea and hot chocolate in that one. And then in the bottom one, I have my coffee stuff. I have a grinder and I have some syrup in there, which I don't use for coffee necessarily, but I've got to-go cups and then just regular coffee. And then I just have my Keurig down right underneath it, kind of in the corner, which works out perfectly. And I have my mugs up there as well. And then the other cabinet I use those copper bins is kind of my snack and cereal cabinet. As you can see, they just work as like a little drawer almost. You can pull them out in those hard to reach spaces. And these cabinets, I have like two of these with the one shelf halfway. And they can be a little bit awkward, but I've tried to just make the best of it. And what you're looking at here is my cereal boxes from the Dollar Tree. I think they're like a 3-quart size, if you could see that. And I also have this one that I had managed to find one time. You can rarely find the big ones, but I think I have like one of them. And yeah, I have a smaller one as well. Those you can usually find a lot if you are looking for the shaker type of thing. But I like to take out all of my snacks and stuff as best as I can anyway. I like to take them out of their packaging and then just put them directly into the bins. It frees up so much more space. So yeah, this is just kind of my snack and cereal cupboard, as I said. The next cabinet here is where I keep most of my cooking and bakeware, I guess. I have a corner organizer, as you can see there. I think it's meant for dishes or something, but yeah, it worked well for that. And these pans I just stack on top of each other. One tip is to just put the lid upside down, that way you can put it on top of each other. And I also have a little command hook to keep my strainer on. And then the rest of it is pretty self-explanatory. I just try to use the vertical space as much as possible, and I have to stack stuff kind of on top of each other. I do have space where I could put like pans I don't use as much, but this is kind of my, yeah, just my everyday cookware. And in here is like a corner cabinet where I have my dishes I don't use as much. But the main thing I wanted to show you is that I keep my toaster in here. I have an outlet right underneath it, and so I don't even need to get it out. It's very handy, it's out of sight, and yet it's easily accessible. So I just keep that there, and along with my French press, which is right beside my coffee cupboard. So that works good, and yeah, that's how the corner cabinet looks. So this is where I keep all of our dishes and glassware that we use like on a daily basis. I have my favorite copper bins up at the top again. I keep water bottles and the boys' stuff And then in the corner here, I have our dishes on another one of those corner organizers, and glasses at the bottom, and then just bowls and plates on the other side. And I do have the black poster board in all of our top cabinets, in case you were wondering. I did not put them in the bottom ones, just harder to get to, and these are ones that you see more, and I still just really love how it looks. And this next cabinet is one where I keep like all of my baking mixes, my nuts and chocolate chips, just baking type of things mostly. And some of the things I label if I don't know what it is, but I'm using one of those shaker things from the Dollar Tree again. All of these containers, except for the mason jar maybe there that you see, are from the Dollar Tree. I love these containers. They're not necessarily airtight, but as long as you don't use them for, like, keep stuff in it for a long, long time, it's usually fine. There are two glass ones that I have there. But I love how everything looks. I can see everything, and yet it's all uniformed, and it was only a dollar. So yeah, I love that cabinet. And right below that cabinet, I have a container or a caddy spinner thing that I keep all of the, you know, cooking utensils, just because I don't have a lot of drawers. I do have two other drawers where I keep more utensils, and this one is straight across from the oven, and I have everything separated into little containers for the most part. Held in place by sticky tack at the bottom so they don't slide around. And yeah, these I think came from Dollar Tree or Dollar General, and I just love that I can separate things and have them all contained. And right beside it, I have a drawer for our flatware and just our regular utensils that we use. So that's where we keep that. And showing you another food cabinet, this right here is the DIY turntable that you can do from like Dollar Tree or anywhere really. You can get cake pans, like round cake pans, and put marbles in it, and you can use it as a spinner. It works really well. These blue containers I got from Walmart a long while ago already, but I just contain things inside each one of them. And then these containers up here are also from Dollar Tree. I have like my Jell-O's in one, Jell-O's and puddings in one, and then in the other container I have like cake decorating supplies or like cupcake stuff. And moving to the cabinet beside that, I have all of my spices, my oil, and just, you know, the things that you use for cooking. And I have this wonderful two-tier turntable. Guys, I love turntables. They're like the absolute best for organizing. And I have another DIY thing. Yeah, just put marbles in between two, and there you have a simple little turntable if you don't want to go spend, you know, a little bit more on just your regular one. But yeah, that is how I have my spices organized. And here you have my not so glamorous under the sink cabinet. Yeah, not the prettiest thing around, but it's functional. I just have some cleaners and soap and paper towel in the one container, and then I have my dishwasher tabs and rinse aid in another one. And then right beside that, I have like my sponges and things like that in the other one. So that, along with my KitchenAid mixer, which is right beside all this, that is what I kind of keep in there for the most part. And then the last place I think I'm going to show you is my Lazy Susan in the corner. I'm really thankful to have it. It's not huge, but it definitely serves a really good purpose. I just have some mechanical type things, and then my mixing bowls and some choppers, and yeah, like I have my sugar, flour, brown sugar, that kind of stuff that I have in there. And that covers the bulk of my organization, guys. I think I'm just gonna quit with that. It's already longer than I wanted. But yeah, I hope you all enjoyed it and found it helpful. Just wanna say thank you guys so much for all your love and your support and all the new subscribers, guys. I'm just overwhelmed, and I'm so excited that you guys are joining me here on this journey. So if you are new here, I would just love if you would subscribe and give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. I will be talking to you guys later. Bye!